John Berman. It is Monday, July 25th. It is 3 a.m. in the East. We are live this morning at the CNN Grill. It's not a barn, it's a bar. This is the city of brotherly love, but so far, the main brotherly interaction is of the Cain and Abel variety. We're not talking about Tim Cain, no. Just hours before the Democratic convention is set to gavel in, the Democratic national chair has checked out. Debbie pulling in over the corner.
We got surprises
some
all morning.
Arrivals. You know, that's just the way it's going to happen here at 3 a.m. here.
Surprises all morning for you, so stay tuned. Let me talk first, Josh. Look, politics can be dirty, right? This really sort of shows exactly what was going on, appears to show what was going on behind the scenes. How damaging is this for the unity of the party?
Well, there's a big difference here between the Democratic Party unity and the Republican Party unity. Remember, we had this problem for the party, but for the Clinton campaign, for Democratic unity, they are...
This tees you up nicely, because nothing says unity like getting rid of the chair of the entire party on the eve of the convention.
They're all unified in that they all hate Debbie Wasserman Schultz.
But then you're making Josh Rogan's argument. It's actually, this is a problem that they actually already solved. And the Republican Party created its own chaos. And this chaos was created by the Russian intelligence services intentionally.
And now Hillary Clinton has her own show this week. And she was asked on 60 Minutes last night. She was asked basically, crooked Hillary. We heard about crooked Hillary all week. You know, does she have something similar for Donald Trump? Does she have her own nicknames? Listen to what she said. So, John Phillips, 4 days of lock her up, and she's not going to respond in kind. Is that the right approach? I mean, you support Donald Trump. So, do you think this is the right approach?
She spent the last 3 weeks using Elizabeth Warren as her human Uzi of insults on the campaign trail. So, I have a feeling if she doesn't...
You know, Bob Beckel, 4 days of attacks like that on Hillary Clinton that went largely unresponded, do you think it will leave a mark on her?
No, I mean, it was Darth Vader's, where we're going to come together and raise our kids and all that. There's a perfect comparison, big story. I think when Trump realizes that he's got against him, when Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders and the rest of them hit the campaign trail, who's he got to speak for him?
You don't think does he get a bounce, though? I mean, we'll know soon enough, but do you think those 4 days of lock her up and the tone of his speech is something that's going to do well for him?
Yeah, well, ultimately, I think he gets a small bounce, and then she gets a small bounce, and then it's settled, as it is for her.
It's subtle, though, Angela Rye, because the Clinton people get in mud with Donald Trump. It's just what they do is they say he's unfit, temperamentally unfit to be president, which if you're trying to, like, make it short in 5 words, is crazy. They're trying to say he's crazy.
Well,
there you go.
Hey, I think that the thing that is interesting here is it's not just Hillary's campaign who's saying that. You have, and this is a partisan thing, as Americans writ large, we should be concerned about the type of presidency Donald Trump is in the White House.
Have you told anyone that?
No, Christine just inspired me because she kept saying, lock her, lock her up. I was like, lock it up.
If we hear that, can we say it was born on early start at 3:47 a.m.?
I think that you can do whatever you want.
As they say in kindergarten, zip it, lock it, put it in your pocket.
Let's keep it going
because that's right in Donald Trump's schoolhouse.
There's one guy's got as much riding on this almost as Hillary Clinton, that's Barack Obama. He can't stand Donald Trump.
Yeah. Donald Trump speaks for himself, and I think that explains part of his appeal.
Speaking of big people, he actually does have someone who's a former or a current sitting governor actually working for him. Sorry, big people was kind of shade. But Chris Christie, you're right. Mike is running mate. Yeah, you see what I did there? It's too early for that. But yes, that's exactly right. He has attack dogs, and whether you want to call them conventional or not.
Don't forget Ted Nugent. He's there with him.
That's true. Yeah. Ted Rudy Nugent, Giuliani. Bruce Springsteen. That's going to be a
Pat. Bruce Springsteen does not support Trump.
No. I know what I'm saying is that he's got Ted Nugent, but she's got Bruce Springsteen, so it's like the battle of the bands.
Bruce Springsteen. I don't want to speak for him. Seems like a Bernie guy.
Listen,
guess.
That means
listen,
he's not a Donald let's talk Trump about. Guy. You're going to hear from Hillary Clinton supporters this week. You're going to hear from people she says who she's helped throughout her career. Is that the way to go? I mean, is that the way to highlight instead of going negative or keeping the tone dark?
I've talked to Clinton aides all weekend. What they said is this: they're like they think that the Republicans and the Democrats are living in two different realities. Convince Americans that that's not the case, and the only way they can do that is by having people present an alternate reality, what they believe to be the real reality. That's their mission. That's what they're thinking.
But you guys are going to be here all week. Does anyone here think that we're going to... God, I can't believe they didn't say anything about Donald Trump, I'm willing to bet right now they're going to say a lot.
The convention wasn't positive. But, I'll tell you, she's got one thing to do. Forget policy, forget everything else. She's got to deal with her negatives. It's not a balance here, either one of them, because Trump can't get above 41, and she can't get above 43. It's not a balance here, either one of them, because Trump can't get above 41, and she can't get above 43.
The Clinton campaign also tells me that they see an opportunity on the foreign policy stuff, right? It used to be a sore spot for her because her record as Secretary of State is mixed. The Middle East is a